so that we, but if it's at the start, then that is okay. So, no problem. No problem. If it is at the start, because if it was within, then we would have apportioned your, the first one, we take the profits equally, then the other side we apportion. So, X, Y, Z. Xavier, Yvonne, and Zari. Income statement. So, sales. Ninyi ndio mlifanya hiyo swali. You are the people who did that question. Was there, were we given sales?
No.
Look about.
Sales. What about receipts from customers?
Receipts from customers can just help us, but receipts can. You cannot say what you receive from customer, that is the sales, no? So, when you have to go power and relax too, you bring until you want it, aiko. So just leave the sales hanging. Now, Steve, after this is also incomplete. Aye, less cost of sales. Cost of sales. Were we given the opening inventory?
Yes.
Yeah.
Inventory. Opening inventory. You copy?
120. Channel balance.
90. How much? 120. 120. We add what? Purchases. So purchases.
Payment to trade suppliers.
Oh, I'll also check note number five. Check note number five. As of 30th April, trade payables were valued at how much? 105. So we paid payment to trade suppliers was 330. We paid 330, yes. We paid 330, but at the end of the year, we have not paid how much? 105. So you combine with that note number five. you add the 105. So that you have 330 plus 105. That is 4.5. Then closing inventory. Were we given?
No.
Right?
Closing inventory, we are not given.
It was not provided. Eh?
Yeah.
Probably is nice. So it means you don't have here. Then gross profit. Gross profit, they are saying 50% on cost of sales. So here we don't have cost of sales here. So we don't, if we have this, we multiply this, we get here, then we want that one to get sales in Asia. But now that one is also missing. So let's get sales first. So sales, in that note, in that cash book, how much did they receive receipts from customers? We received from customers how much? 516. Then in note number six, they say, as of 30th April 2017, trade receivables were valued at 120, while the balance were valued at 12. So you see, when you prepare trade receivables, account, balance brought down was not equal, but trial balance. Yes.
90.
Yes.
90.
So opening balance was 90. Then we receive, you know, when you receive your credits, then you debit the cash book. The way they have done, right? So cash received, we received how much? 516.
Yes.
In the cash book. Then bad debts. Bad debts, they are saying, I wanted to 12. Then balance carried down. They are saying balance carried down is 120.
No, 120.
Yes, 120. So the balancing figure here, is the sales. Sales is what will make the receivables to go up. So the balance here represents sales. So can you do for me that favor? And to that effect, I've also noticed that we messed in purchases because there was payables at the beginning. It's not now people at a balance. There was opening payables, not more important in your beginning.
Yes.
Yeah. So to rectify purchases, let's get this one first. Let's get the sales here. So sales is the balancing figure. 516 plus 12 plus 120 minus 90. 558.
Yes.
558. So that is our sales. We bring it here. So even purchases, I've realized we missed. There is something we never capture. So prepare trade payables here. Trade payables. Trade payables. Balance brought down. Yes?
120.
Then payment. When we pay, we credit. We debit the account. Payments. So suppliers were paid 330. Then closing payables, you know, number 5 was 105. Balance carried down is 105. So the balancing figure, this side, is the purchases. Purchases is the balancing figure. This is purely incomplete records. So 330 plus 105 minus 120. 315. So purchases is 315. Now, Elizabeth, Erastus, are you okay there?
Yes, yes.
Isabel?
Yes.
Very good. So, now the task here is now to get gross profit. You see, once we have gross, we'll take this minus gross to part the cost. Then after that, we can get this. We'll say this plus this minus this, we get here. So when given they have said gross profit is 50% of cost of sales. So I want to remind you something. I want to remind you something. There is something we call markup. Markup is equals to gross profit over cost of sales times 100%. We did it during incomplete. While margin is equals to gross profit over sales times 100%. So in this question, they are saying that gross profit is 50% of cost of sales. When they mention cost, that is markup. But now you see that one cannot work because gross profit we don't have. Cost of sales, we don't have. So even if you have 50, it cannot help you to get anything because the two are unknown. So if this one cannot work, then you convert markup into margin. Because this one will work. If we have margin, what is missing is gross profit because sales is there. So to convert, so in this case, markup is 50%. 50% is 50 over what? 100. So no.
Yes.
So to convert markup to margin, you add numerator to the denominator. Equal to. So margin will be 50 over 150. That is the margin.
So if we have the margin, then you say is equal to GP, which we don't know, divided by sales, which is 550 what? 58. So from there, you can get the gross profit. So the gross profit will be 50 over 150 times 558. I'm getting 186. 186. Then to get gross profit, the cost of sales, take 558 minus 186. So 558 minus that, you get here to be 372. So 372. So you take this plus this minus that, you get closing stock. So 120 plus 315 minus the answer, closing stock is 63. Question. Check how we have gotten those answers. Check how we have gotten the answers.
Erastus.
Yes.
Nisaidie hiyo ya trade payables.
Yes.
Ni piga picha nitumie WhatsApp.
Oh. Thank you.
Erastus.
Yes.
Ulikuwa umefanya hizo wali?
Eh?
Uliweza kufanya hizo question?
Nilijaribu.
Mi hadi sikuanza.
Eh?
I had not even started.
Eh. Lakini sina nasikia unashika shika.
Ah, sahi sasa iko poa.
Eh?
Yeah. Inakuja sasa. Alafu vile vitu ni ngumu hivi na Isabel alikuwa anataka kukosa.
Eh?
Vile ziko ngumu.
Yeah.
Alafu Isabel alikuwa anakosa.
Yeah, yeah. Trade payables, si nimemtumia? Au?
Umemtumia?
Yeah.
Sawa.
Usaanza nini expenses?
Ah, mimi nimetoka na nini. Bado niko na lala.
Eh, na wewe unarahukanga?
Yeah.
Jiu mmesoka soka. Haya. But umeelewa?
How can one convert margin to markup?
So we subtract numerator from denominator.
So like there it was 50 denominator.
So in kama ugebewa kama hii. Kama ingekuwa hivi, initial margin, the markup will be 50 over 50. All right, so less expenses.
Hello?
Yes, Rastas. Rastas? Hello? Okay. Rastas, I'm still going to go down.
Hello? Hello? Can you now hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Yeah, I'm asking.
Yes.
About changing margin to markup.
You subtract numerator from denominator.
Okay.
Very good. All right. So let's bring expenses. Where are they?
Accrued expenses. Accrued user balance.
But accrued, you know, accrued is a liability. So check cash book. Cash book there is operating. Are you seeing operating expenses?
Yes.
There is operating expenses in the cash book. Oh,
thanks. Yes.
Yes.
Then, as a starting prepaid rent, that's a operating expenses we have to begin because when you are operating expenses in the rent, so it will be 90 prepaid rent as a 30th April you subtract. So minus 30 plus accrued electricity of 6. It will be part of that because we cannot see rent and electricity anywhere. So you bring them here. So it will be 90 minus 30 plus 6. It will be 66. Then let me draw. Not number three. Plant and machinery is depreciated at the rate of 10% of straight line. So depreciation, plant and machinery. Check the value of plant and machinery at the start.
300.
Check cash book. In the cash book, there was purchase of new plant on the payment side. 150. Then there is a plant which was disposed. There is a plant which was disposed. That was sale of what? That's what we got. We got 30, but we need to see the what was the value of that plant. Number four. The old plant sold during the year had been purchased in June 2009 at a cost of how much?
180.
So minus 180. Then what remains? You depreciate at what percentage?
10.
That one plus. The acquisition minus the one is cost. So that is 300 plus 150.
minus 180 to 70.
What about the number of years depreciation?
That one is very important for us to check gain or loss of disposal. You know, when we disposed, I want to check whether we gained or we lost. When we disposed, the net book value of that asset, it was 180. Times 10%, how many years? We are in which year? May 2017.
7 years.
7. It was purchased in 2009. So 2009, 2010, 1, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16.
7 years.
7. There are 7 years. Because the year you disposed, they have said you don't depreciate. So it is 209, 20, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Usifika 2017, they have said the year you're disposed to not depreciate. So that's 7 years. Now, net book value will be, you take the cost of that asset, which was 180, minus the accumulated depreciation. Accumulated depreciation times 7 years. So the book value of that asset, that is 180 times 10 times 7 years, 126, or 180 minus this, you get 54. So the book value of that asset was 54. Receipt on disposal, we disposed it for how much?
30.
It was disposed at 30, so we lost.
Yes.
So we lost 24. Because book value was 54, but we got only that. So loss on this person. Loss on this person, 24. We lost 24. Then there was bad debts. Bad debts, 12,000. You know, number 6. Unless there is something I've forgotten, or we have not captured, you can tell me.
Question.
Yes.
In exam, you are supposed to show the working.
But I must. Nobody marks those workings. Okay. Your workings are good on but I mark. You just have to do them. Nobody will mark them. So add for me the expenses. So net profit
57.
So I want to capture the other side. So net profit 57. Then partnership after net profit you go to appropriation.
account. Appropriation account. So there was interest on what?
On opening net balance.
So interest on capital, even current account. They were charging interest at what percentage? 10%. So take 10% times the capital. This one was 90. So that is 9. This one will be 10% times 84. This is 10% of 96. So that is 9. Plus 84, plus 96, 27. You subtract. Then interest on current accounts. You want to say that? They are saying for capital. Let's just do it yourself. So, X. 10% of 6, that is 600. Y, 10% of 12 is 1200. Z, 10% of 12, like you 12 years, Z, now I go inside.
Yes.
May you capture? That is negative, right? Yes, that is negative. So it about to 600. There was no interest on drawings. So can you get the remaining profit? That is 57 minus 27 minus 600. 29,400. Then I'll share that profit. Profit share X, Y, Z in the ratio of 3:2:1. 3:2:1 is 3/6 times 29,400. 2/6 times 29,400. 1/6 times 29,400. $14,700. $98,100. $49,000. $29,400. Nil.
So I want us to proceed. Let us mute yourself. So I want us to prepare current accounts and capital accounts. Even if they are not asked as in both data and balance sheet. So partners, current accounts. So we start. So balance brought down. Balance brought down current account. This was 6. This was 12. This one was coming this side. You are going to require a sign on the debit. Sure. Yes. Then now, everything in appropriation. Let up. So interest on capital 9,84,96. Then interest on current account 600. 12,500, yeah, we will not put inside. Interest on current account. That 12,500 comes negative comes this side. Then profit share 14,798.49. Then drawings, you debit the accounts. drawings in the cash book, 30, 33, then 36. Question. If there was interest, listen to this. If there was interest on drawings, you don't subtract, you add back. Because interest on drawings means mkwalichukua pesa kwa biashara na kurudisha na interest. So you add, then you come and debit it, yeah, interest on drawings to reduce their balances. So balance carried down, these balances here become the core carried down this side. All of them will be negative from what I can see. Sure. So this is 6 plus 9 plus 600 plus 14,700. 3,300. So balance carried down is 300. You put the 3,300. Then 12 plus 84 plus 1,200 plus 98 is 31. 12 plus 84 plus 1,200 plus 98. 31,400. So this one will balance this side. Its balance carried down will be this side because this is 33, so this is small. So 33 minus the answer is 1,600. Then 12 plus 12 plus 36 is 49,200 minus 96 minus 49, 34,700. Hebu maliza kuone kama uko salama.
Hello, Steve.
Yes.
Sasa umesema una nini? Ebu hiyo nini partners capital account?
Partners? Hello?
Capital account. Ebu the receipt side.
At partners capital account.
The debit side. Tuko na balance carry down of 12,000.
Tuko kwa current account.
Atujaanza current account. Si
tumeachia kupata. Hii ni current. Yeah.
Ini not partners. Not capital.
This is current account.
Okay.
So
now on the nini? On the debit side.
Uh-huh.
Kuna balance carried forward of 12,000.
Yes, yes, carried now.
Yeah.
Yes.
Alafu interest on capital 1,200.
Yes, yes, interest 1,200. Yes, interest on current account.
On current?
Yes, on current account.
1,200.
This one here. Studio.
Yes, yes. You.
Uh-huh.
I love to connect drawings. See you.
Drawings is always the current. Is that the music? Cash.
The other side. Hello?
The other side.
The other side took on a balance brought down interest, yes, on capital.
Alafu na interest on capital.
Alafu.
Interest on current account, profit share, and then now you balance.
Okay.
What is your question?
Ew.
Sir.
Yes. Capital accounts. Partners. Capital accounts. Then balance brought down. Balance brought down, this is 90. 84. 96. Check. Before cash flow, collect your dot dots. Your dots check dot number 3. 1, 2, 3. Agreed to be valued at 300 million. What was the value of land and building up there? To 10. That is an increase of
90.
You share to them. Revaluation gain. Revaluation gain. That 90 shared in the ratio of 3:2:1. So that is 45. The first one will be 45. Party. Fifteen. Sure. Then bulletin 2. Goodwill was agreed at 180, but another account for goodwill is not to be maintained in the accounting records. So goodwill. Goodwill. So that goodwill. Okay, Yahoo will need to help us. Because you know that it was 18, 180. Yes. So first of all, take 180 divided by 3, and get the equal 1. 60. Then you write it off. Goodwill is not maintained. Right? So you write it off by everything. Goodwill written off. But now you write off in the ratio of 3:2:1. So 180. This one will be 90. This is 60. This is 30. So balance carried down. So here we share goodwill in the ratio of 1:1:1. Initially it was sharing equal. Yes. Then you write it off in the new ratio. So that will be 90 + 45. +60 - 90. This is 105. 84 + 90 - 60 = 114.
96 plus 15 plus 60 minus 30, 141. So doing the balance sheets. And current assets, land and buildings, take the revalued amount, 300. It was revalued to 300,000. Land and machinery, what is land and machinery for us to remit? Because you see, the cost of land and machinery was 300. Eh? Then we disposed, it's a credit producer.
Yes.
And it was having a cost of how much? 180. We got not number four.
Yes.
So we subtract disposal. Then there was accumulated depreciation. So minus. So now you're 198. The problem now. The 180, you know, its accumulated depreciation is also here. So subtract depreciation on disposal of this. It was 180 times 10 times 7 years. No?
Yes.
We depend on the account. 180 times 10 times 7. 126. The depreciation. 126. So what you do, you, this is the remaining cost, this is the remaining depreciation. So 198 minus 136 is 72. 300 minus 180 minus 72. What is remaining is only 48. Confirm. This minus this is to help us get the cost of the remaining. This minus this is to help us get the
180.
You keep your correct. Check here. Let's calculate it outside. Above about outside working. Plant and machinery cost. Cost you will take 300 minus 180. This is 120.
Yes.
Less accumulated depreciation. Accumulated depreciation is 198 minus 196 minus 126. This was coming to 72. It was coming to 72. Then less depreciation for the year.
deep for the year. The year we got how much? Ebu check for me the depreciation of plant and machinery. In the income statement, what did we charge?
$27.
Yes. So minus 27. Minus 27. So you will have 120 minus 72 minus 27. You get 21. Have you understood what we have done? The remaining cost, the remaining accumulated, then what you charge for the year. Then you get the remaining cost there to be 21. All right, current assets, inventory, closing. Closing, we were not even calculated. What did we get? What did we get for stock?
63,000.
Yes. Receivables, checkbook or chini, note number 6, 120. Cash, check cash book. Check the cash book. Cash book, you can have anything with?
9,000.
But you got a 9. You cash pay like it's good. So bank 9. No, 9 was the balance broke down in the bank. So no, your cash book on each other.
It's at the beginning.
Beginning, still. Then what I reconcile in a balance. So there is nothing. Prepaid. There was something prepaid. Prepaid what?
Prepaid rent.
Prepaid rent. That was 30. I don't think it's there is something. But at least now we're going to confidence to approach you as well. In case someone brings something like this. Senior. 230. So that one was 321, it comes to 534. Total assets. Capital and liabilities. Capital accounts. X, Y, Z. Then current accounts. X, Y, Z.
So capital accounts, they are there, 105, 114, 141. So that is 105 plus 114 plus 141, 360. Then current accounts, 316, that is negative. It should not balance this side, that's negative. That side was more. Then 34, 700 is also negative. So 300 minus 16, minus 34, 700, negative 36. So 360 minus there, so you get 324. So, una loan, 10% loan, right?
Yeah.
My current liabilities, there is 10% loan. Una loan, mahali. Loan, the government? 120. The loan is 120. Then current liabilities, payables, payables check note number 6, payables 105, something was accrued, accrued electricity 6,000, accruals 6, Quisha. Accrued expenses. Eh? Yeah, there was accrued expenses in the total balance of how much?
15.
15. So it is 15 plus 6. Eh? 15 plus 6, 21. So that one is 126. You see that, Jew? No pana gabi. Can you add? Buat dia lah punya. What are you getting, Isabel?
Yes,
very
na hii ni 534. A difference of 36. Hiyo ni 6 na tuletea shida hapa ndio. Sindo?
Michelle,
you don't care. Siko sawa. Hapa examina sometimes. That is much okay. Steve, we've got a perfect concept. You read your backup, imagine your concept. Yeah, you complete. Mm-hmm. Isabel, you Isabel, you go well.
Yes.
Unapata ngapi hapo chini? What are you getting? 570.
Yes.
A difference of 36, maybe addition of that 36. We don't care about that. So in the next class, I will check what we are doing, company control accounts or company's accounts. I'll check what we are supposed to do. Enjoy your holiday. You must tell on a holiday. Enjoy your holiday. Still can see me.
Isabel. 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 Isabel.
Amen. Isabel.
Steve.
Rastas.
Steve.
Yes. Sema.
Umesema hiyo nini inakuja 570?
Zile toto ni saba chini.
Eh. Yeah. 570 flat.
Yeah.
570 flat.
Yeah, 570 flat. Hii tuongeza notes. Hizo approvals. Alafu na hiyo ndio tumebada hapa. Sasa hii 570. Na hii ilikuwa 534.
Sawa.
So like kuna hiyo difference ya 36.
Mm. So mpaka next week.
Yeah?
So tutakutana next week.
Yeah, sasa mpaka next week. Holiday yeah. Unasema aje?
Siku pata nafasi bwana.
Eh.
Eh.
Ah, nauliza na holiday hii leo.
Eh?
Uko nyumbani?
Eh, niko nyumbani.
Okay, sawa sawa.
Yes.
Umemaliza kuandika? Rastas?
Yes.
Umemaliza kuandika?
Yes, yes.
Okay, sawa.
Ebu fanya hivi?
Yeah.
Ebu tilt hiyo nini side ya left. I mean right. Right.
Bravo.
No.
Yeah?
Tena.
Wapi hapo?
Ikienda left.
Ugu.
Hivyo. Ebu songeza tu.
Uko sawa?
Sawa.
Umemaliza?